Hello there, my name is McHorse, and welcome to the fourth episode of Blockbuster tutorial series. In this video, I'll show you how to synchronize camera with scenes. So first, you need to install Aperture mod. For this tutorial, you'll need Aperture 1.5 or above. If you don't know how to use Aperture mod, feel free to watch the Aperture Academy series in the top right corner. Once Aperture mod is installed, and you're in a Minecraft world, open Scenes panel, select the scene you want to synchronize the camera with, and then either press C on the keyboard, or click the Edit Camera button, and it will open the camera editor. If you'll scrub over the timeline, you'll see that actors are synchronized with the cursor in timeline. Once you've finished previewing actors, you can exit the camera editor. However, actors won't disappear, which is normal. To remove actors, you have to stop the playback of the scene, for example by pressing play slash pause key bind, which is right control by default. While this might look enough, there are still lots of options to show. In the camera options, at the bottom of the modal, there are scene options. Detach scene button allows to unbind currently bound scene, which was bound through the edit camera button. You can also use shift plus D key combination to detach currently bound scene. Once currently bound scene was detached, the scene will be stopped, and all damage will be restored and actors will be gone. If you want to synchronize previous scene with camera editor, you'd have to go back and press the edit camera button again. Reload actors toggle allows you to toggle reloading of the scene upon entering the camera editor. Preview actions toggle allows you to toggle preview of actors' actions. For example, if you have a scene with lots of explosions, it allows you to avoid the lag due to destruction of terrain. However, this option only affects the scrubbing, and not playback preview. Reload scene button allows you to manually reload the scene, without having to exit the camera editor. This is useful, again, when you have something destructive, and you want to scrub back and see the scene again. However, the scene is still damaged, by clicking on reload scene button, or by pressing shift plus R key combination, you can reload the scene, and everything should be more or less back, up to the point of where cursor is. For details and limitations of damage restoration, feel free to check out a dedicated video about damaged control system in the top right corner. And finally, audio shift field allows you to edit scene's audio shift property without exiting the camera editor. You can find out more about it in a separate video about in-game audio synchronization, in the top right corner. And finally, after you edited the camera for currently bound scene, you can record some video footage. Either hide the GUI elements on the screen by pressing F1, and start recording the camera playback with a screen recording software like OBS. Or, you can record the footage right in the game using the Minima mod. However, first, you have to install and configure it. See the video in top right corner. Once Minima is installed and configured, there is a Minima panel right next to the save button. What it does is allows you to record some video footage without exiting the camera editor. Here you can specify an output name, and the recording mode, before recording the footage. There is also this convenient button to open the capture paths folder. Output name can be anything. However, make sure that there is no file with the same name in the capture paths folder, because if there is, Minima won't be able to record the video. While recording mode allows you to choose which portion of the camera profile to record, you can pick either entire camera profile, selected fixture, or custom region. When custom region is selected, set start and set duration buttons allow you to automatically calculate start and duration values using the position of the cursor in the timeline. Once you configured everything, you can press record button to record the footage. Once Minima stops recording, you'll be able to watch the video footage it recorded. And finally, I'll show you an alternative and older way of attaching a camera to a scene. Go to Creative Inventory, and grab a playback button from Blockbuster's tab. This item allows you to playback a specific scene, and optionally a camera profile. Grab the playback button item in your main hand, and open Scenes panel. Click on the Attach button, and a screen will pop up. At the moment, neither the scene nor a camera profile were attached to the playback button yet. We need to pick the camera profile first. To do that, you have to switch the camera mode to load and play, and then pick the camera profile you want to use in the list. Then press done button. If you'll press escape key instead, the picked scene and camera profile won't be attached to the playback button, so make sure to click the done button. If you'll right click the button, the scene and camera will start playing together. To stop the playback early, press Aperture's toggle camera playback, which is Z by default, and right click on the button again to stop the playback of the actors. If you'll enter the camera editor while holding an attached button, you'll be able to synchronize a scene attached to the playback button, rather than the one that was attached in scenes panel. I wouldn't recommend using playback button as the primary tool for editing camera profiles for individual scenes. However, it's fine to use playback buttons once you've finished editing camera profiles, so you can record these scenes in a bulk now or later. That's pretty much it. I hope that this tutorial taught you how to attach scenes to the camera editor, in order to preview and create camera paths for scenes. Thanks for watching, and see you later.
Hey, you. You're finally awake. You were trying to cross the border.
Right?